If you have a barometer, you may have noticed that the air pressure in the past week has twice dropped about as far down the scale as it gets around here. The first time was last Friday, and there was an encore on Monday. Now here's a look at pressure in State College going back to the first of the year, and the unit here is millibars. Here's last Friday, the lowest pressure of the year so far, and there's Monday, the third lowest of the year so far. Signs that the atmosphere can produce some pretty powerful storms in spring, and the centers of the last two have passed right through the state. Now, to be honest, this isn't the actual air pressure at State College. Instead, this is a modified pressure called sea level pressure. The adjustment is needed because you can think of air pressure as the weight of the molecules in a column above a given point. So pressure always decreases with altitude. A simple rule is about an inch of mercury decrease for every 1,000 feet of altitude, or about 1 millibar per 8 meters. This effect of altitude on pressure has to be removed, or else you'll always have lows in the higher elevations and highs in the lower elevations. We make this correction by essentially creating a fake column of air that stretches from sea level to the altitude of the station, and then estimating the pressure of that column. Now, we could use those rules I just mentioned, but pressure depends on temperature, so to be more precise, temperature observations from the station are extrapolated to estimate the temperature and thus the pressure of the fictitious column. That extra pressure is then added to the station pressure to get the sea level pressure. And anytime we report a local pressure or give the pressure of a surface high or low, it's a sea level pressure. With that out of the way, here's a look at sea level pressure going all the way back a full year in State College, back to last April. And notice the maximum over the past year was 1,036 millibars. The minimum was, last Friday, 985 millibars. And most of the time, sea level pressures in the mid-latitudes tend to stay in this fairly narrow range. In fact, average sea level pressure is 1,013 millibars, 29.92 inches of mercury. A strong high pressure system over the lower 48 states might register 1,050 millibars. The highest on record was at the center of a bitterly cold Siberian air mass, 1,084 millibars, 32 inches of mercury, off the scale on most home barometers. On the low side, the March 1993 superstorm was one of the most powerful on record in the East. It bottomed out at 960 millibars. The lowest sea level pressures on Earth belong to hurricanes. Wilma holds the record in the Atlantic, 882 millibars, while the world record belongs to a typhoon in the Western Pacific, 870 millibars. By the way, correcting to sea level pressure does have its issues because errors are introduced when we make those assumptions about temperature in the made-up column. These errors are largest in mountainous regions where maps of sea level pressure are often not very useful. Fred is back with the extended forecast next.
Wow, that was about 10 seconds faster than the last one.
Good.
You want to watch it?
Sure, since it'll take 10 seconds less.
Okay.